Well, there is no shortage of events going on around the Sacramento region coming up this weekend, and one of them is the 24th annual Lamb Festival. Did you know we had a Lamb Festival? We definitely do. It's the 24th year they've had this thing, and Chef Ian McBride from Lucca Restaurants joining us on the patio. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
My parents are Irish, so and Irish people love lamb. Yes. It's fantastic in Ireland. So we ate a lot of lamb growing up. Some people, though, I think are a little nervous about cooking it sometimes, not knowing if they'll know how to cook it correctly.
Treat it pretty much like beef. I mean, don't overcook it if it's a lamb chop or a loin chop or something like that. Leg will take a little bit more time. And it makes great stew.
All right,
obviously,
great.
Well, Irish lamb stew.
Yeah, we eat it all the time. All right, so tell us a little bit about what we're going to do here.
I'm doing lamb chops. I marinate them in a little bit of pomegranate molasses, which is this stuff. Garlic, bay leaf, and olive oil. Then I kind of butterflied it out and made a stuffing of chopped dates and almonds, which we're just going to kind of mash into the
And
chops.
Butterfly, just in lamest terms, means you just slice it open.
Slice it open, squirt it all out. And then we're going to roll it up. And I forgot my butcher's twine, but you get the idea.
Imagine, if you will, butcher's twine.
And we throw it on the grill.
All right.
And you want it kind of a medium heat. You don't want it too hot. The fat renders out pretty quick, and it'll flare up pretty bad. A lot of times I'll cover the bones with foil so they don't burn.
Okay.
This one's been on the grill for quite a while now.
And so it gives it just a nice enough color, but not that charred color.
And then...
And about how long did you say, Ian, to cook it?
For medium, it's probably going to take about 15, 20 minutes.
Okay.
Because, again, you want that lower heat so it doesn't flare up and burn too much.
Are you turning it constantly?
Yeah.
You do. Okay.
Take the strings off and...
Beautiful.
Slice between each rib.
This is perfect.
And then...
It's amazing how much fresh lamb comes from the Dixon area, too, where the festival
takes place. Yeah, there's
a lot of
good farmers. One of our friends of the restaurant, Martin Amy, is one of the suppliers for Superior Farms. He'll be at the festival. I'll be there tomorrow doing a cooking demonstration at 1 o'clock.
Okay.
Different recipe, but
And then let's finish this up so we can show how it got to be so pretty.
Sliced it in just a little bit of arugula with some pomegranate seeds. Pomegranates are just coming into season now. And then a little drizzle of the pomegranate molasses.
And the pomegranates have gotten so popular the last couple of years, especially.
Really
a lot
healthy,
of people really liking that.
The antioxidants and all that.
Great.
They just taste
wonderful
good.
Recipe. You can get a copy of the recipe there at kcra.com. And don't forget to go to the Lamb Festival. It is tomorrow. It starts at 9 in the morning, goes till 9 at night. That's a lot of lamb.
Yes.
12 hours of lamb at the Lamb Festival at the Dixon May Fairgrounds.